Would you like to learn about the process for designing a cloud architecture or enterprise architecture? If so, this video is for you. In this video, we will be discussing the cloud architecture process and the enterprise architecture process. Specifically, we will be introducing Phase B of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. We like to follow the TOGAF framework as it provides a structured and repeatable approach to designing a cloud and enterprise architecture that will drive digital transformation. We also like the TOGAF framework as it's an industry standard, which is used by major players in enterprise architectures like IBM and Microsoft and Cisco and Dell and Intel and VMware, Accenture, Deloitte, and many other key industry players. After developing the architecture vision, the next phase of the enterprise architecture process really begins with developing the business architecture. If you haven't seen the video on developing an architecture vision, you can find it in the description of this video. Also, make sure to watch our other videos that cover more of the TOGAF framework. Developing the business architecture is Phase B of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. Now, developing the business architecture may be the most critical phase of cloud and enterprise architecture process, as if we don't understand how the business operates, there is a significant chance that the architecture will fail to deliver transformation. In fact, without understanding how the business works, it's actually possible that the new technology will harm the business. This is because technology can have a profound effect in the way the business operates, and we need to use the right technology to improve business operations. A perfect example is when the US government mandated electronic health records. Companies then adopted electronic health records almost overnight, and medical errors increased 250%, making medical errors the third leading cause of death in the United States prior to COVID. And this is because no one really looked at the business architecture before implementing the new technology or how the hospitals actually worked. They just adopted technology. Business architecture is how the business operates. It involves looking at the people, the processes, and even to a lesser degree, the technologies that actually support the business. A business architecture will map out, for example, the sales process, the customer service process, the marketing process, literally all major business functions. The first step of driving any kind of digital transformation is mapping out the business architecture, or how the business actually operates today. We need to understand how the business operates as well as the organization's capabilities. We need to map out the entire organization. Are there multiple business units? If so, how do the business units operate independently and interdependently for the entire enterprise? We need to map if the company has external partners. If so, how does the organization work with those external partners? We need to map out all the key business processes. We need to map out the value streams or how the organization makes money. This is our baseline business architecture. Now we need to go back and look at the architecture vision, or how the business desires to operate in the future. So now we need to plan the new business architecture, or how the business will operate in the future. We need to determine what capabilities we want the business to have in the future, and we need to map out the new future business processes for the new business architecture. Next, we really need to perform a gap analysis. We need to find the difference between the current business architecture and the target or to-be business architecture of the future. We need to evaluate all options to go from the current architecture to the future architecture. We need to evaluate all trade-offs between the architectural choices. Let's face it, almost every decision will have an impact on the business. So we're going to need to pick the options, the right options that are right for the business. We need to confirm that the plan to go from the current architecture to the future architecture will then support all business requirements and future goals. Next, we need to conduct a formal stakeholder review of the new business architecture. Now, stakeholders are people who have a vested interest in the organization, its success, and its decision-making. We need to confirm that the architecture will satisfy all stakeholder requirements. Often, architectural choices will help one part of the organization place challenges on another part of the organization. This means we as enterprise architects or cloud architects will often have to do some negotiation between stakeholders to get to the final solution. Then, of course, We need to get buy-in from all the stakeholders so they will support the changes when they're finally implemented. Lastly, we need to finalize the business architecture. Now, we need to fully document the business architecture. We need to document every building block of the architecture. And of course, now we need to store these architecture documents in the architecture repository. And the architecture repository is where all critical architectural documents are stored. Now you know Phase B of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. Of course, this is a high-level overview. If you'd like to have a deeper understanding of this, make sure to look at our training content. The link is in the description below. Whether you use the TOGAF framework or another architecture framework, planning the business architecture is critical for the success of any cloud architecture or enterprise architecture. To learn how to get your first cloud architect job, please download the free ebook. Also, join us for the free webinar on how to become the ultimate cloud architect. The link for both free resources is in the description of this video. If you've liked this video, please give it a like. And also, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new free videos to help you in your cloud architect or enterprise architect career. Look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.